In this world of calamity, dirty looks and grudges and jealousy, and police where you abuse them authority, media clowns when I know about variety. Boom, the youngest veteran I go murder them slow. Ragamuffin sent to call me from the bush bungalow. When I watch it make a clear out my voice now figure out. Emerge from the darkness with me big blood to glow. Me yammer them a slam and spectator get low. Some work with a big like bam bam figure low. Bust off trigger finger, trigger end and trigger toe. A two gun me and me bust them in a stereo. Cause I got to keep on walking on the road to Zion. We got to keep it burning.
What's up? I'm Choki. I'm from Paterson, New Jersey.
So I grew up in Paterson. I was born in Manhattan. It's not the nicest, prettiest city. Definitely underfunded. I went to Eastside High School for a little bit. But, you know, school there is like going to jail, sort of. The police were at metal detectors in the hallways. I kind of never got messed with because I'm Hispanic. And lucky I could talk Spanish, which backs that up. So I never got bothered. But besides that, Paterson's a cruel place. And the bike ride's good exercise. And it helps me get warmed up to work. And it wakes me up.
That's what I do every day to go make pipes for you people. 10 miles a day, 5 miles there, 5 miles back. Where do I go?
And who know? Out of the two paths I said that I was given, I would make a split decision and take the path I was living. Dangerous, young crook nigga, call me the angry nut. Claiming what? 30-30, I'll deal the players cut.
It's my kiln, that's what I use to heat up everything at one temperature. It's the oxygen. It's a warning label on my color. Which warns you, you know, because it's like fine dust. Those are my colors. You can see they're like sand. And that's my torch on high. It gets about probably 3,000 degrees.
Man sitting in the cell, Kevin, come get me out this shit.
Now I done reached it to the point of doing wrong with no regrets, from breaking doors and pulling jacks and snatching baguettes off your necks. Whatever it takes to ease my aches and stop my shakes when I'm not awake. Consequences make me wait, but consequences don't make me pay. Say Lucci, fuck it, gon' grab a tool, my nigga tuck it. Let's go make ruckus, and in this house is make deductions. These motherfuckers.
That's how I add the color into the glass. Then I melt it in like that. And I kind of push the colors in with my graphite tools. Now I'm about to shape it. Basically, I just do that over and over. Can't stop moving my hands because of gravity. Those glasses I have to wear because they block out the bright light.
On the way I'm chilling as if I'm being a villain. Fuck the consequences, ain't no worse than how the hell I'm.
My life ain't never been easy, so I keep doing what I do. Smoking weed, ease my mind and keep my focus off of you. Scoping you, peeping you, ready to rob and take your life. Put this rope around your throat and get the strangling you tight.
And
take the cash.
That's pretty much how I make a piece.
Got a wife and I got kids, so ain't no stopping me. I'm Priscilla Pinero, and I'm 18 years old. I'm from Newark, New Jersey. How did I meet Choki? It was the winter of last year, around this time. I was walking in Union Square and saw him with his table. And I was like, hey dude, I know you, man. And I was like, we smoked in the wintertime a long time ago. And I named all of his friends. I was like, oh yeah, I remember you, blah, blah, blah. I went to upstate, and that's when I guess I got pregnant. I'm 6 months. That's what I'm due in March. Want to see a picture? Right. Around there. It's a boy. Gotta try to get my own place and just raise my baby. Be a mom. That's my job. Should be a mom. You know? And have a love I never had. You know, have it with me every day. 24/7. My baby.
Ah, you were drinking?
Boy, I love that ball.
He was fucking
I
drinking.
Wouldn't be celebrating.
This is a Heineken. I should get paid for the advertisement, but I'm not. Because you guys are in college and drinking is bad. You drink, you're gonna get like me. That's what happens. Do your studies and become George Bush's assistant.
All right, how about start with, I guess, blowing glass.
Why I got into blowing glass. I was in Venice Beach with my last $200. This guy, which was like my best friend, was like, look, this guy I know makes pipes, and we could sell pipes on the beach for money. And I was like, yeah, right, that's stupid, because I'm from the East Coast. In the West Coast, pipes are for heady nuggets. And me and my friend wasted $400 on pipes that we didn't make, and we sold it on the beach. And that first day, matter of fact, the first 3 hours, we made $300 out of the $400. And we still had money left over, and that's when I knew that I have to make the tools of the trade. But at the moment, I was driving a Volkswagen bus, and I had my glass equipment in it. And I would park at campground sites, and, you know, you make believe you're going camping, but instead of camping, you're blowing glass. And then from there, I just traded pipes for gas. And that's how I got around California. And I didn't have a license, insurance, fictitious plates. I was just driving a Volkswagen bus, waiting to get pulled over. You know what I mean? That's it, I was waiting, and I got pulled over, and the cop was like, you got a license and registration? I was like, yeah, it's buried in the back somewhere, and my shit was a mess. And the cop looked inside my bus and was like, all right, I believe you, carry on, and I got away. Another 5,000 miles, and then I got pulled over in Kings County. And they searched me, and I had no license, no nothing. They take my ride, and they basically leave me on foot, and that's about 300 miles from the girl I was with's house, which I guess that's where I was living. If I'm not living in my bus, I'm living at somebody's house. But if it's not mine, it's usually a female's, because I don't sleep over a guy's house too many times. Unless they have a sister. Which you should keep away from me. But anyway, besides sister loving. On that note, I went from that to Michigan. And I worked for Stony Creek, which was the biggest distributor on the East Coast of glass. And they gave me everything. Every single piece of glass I needed without paying a dollar for it. And that's what got me stuck on making the same style of pipes. Because they would, if I was broke, they'd say, make 100 of these and I give you $500. I can make 100 pipes in 5 days. So you make $500 a week, basically in 2 hours a day. Which is, you know, not that big of a deal. You get big money, you waste it, and then you're like still, you're still at the same position, except with different responsibilities. And the responsibilities could mean a lot to you or not, because you're still living like you was when you was 16, 17.